People came from as far as Omaheke, Oshana, the two Kavango East and West, as well as the Otelenjupa region. The prayer session was an emotional one as the people recounted the events of that horrific day. Human limbs were scattered around the scene of the accident, a scenario which made the law enforcement agents' work difficult to assemble them to the specific bodies of origin. One man who miraculously survived the scene allegedly found himself in the trailer from backseat of the bus. It was indeed horrible. The organizer of the session, Paulinus Kanjimi, told NBC News that he initiated the idea to commemorate the 10th anniversary with a prayer to set historical mark to remember the day.
It was out of my heart, out of the respect of the people who are lying here, as a Namibian. I think this date must be remembered, just like also other days, which are we remembering in Namibia? We have 26th of August 1966. We have 4th of May 1976. So this day, we want it also to be on the Namibian calendar.
Kanjimi says, together with other family members, more plans are underway to make the site a memorable place because many victims left small children behind who have now grown up and are puzzling as to where exactly their loved ones perished. He described the prayer session as a success and urged interested Namibians to join the initiative, which is striving to build a statue or a monument at the site. Since the carnage on national roads continues unabated, Kanjimi had the following to say.
Road users, please stick to the rule. Stick to the rule, especially my request goes to the minibus drivers. Minibus drivers, when you are departuring, check your vehicle. And I want to also request them and tell them and give them this information. They have the right to go to the traffic office anywhere in this country, their vehicle to be checked free of charge, rather than coming to the road and then they will find faults.
Alphonse Maketo, NBC News, Grootfontein.